Welcome back to Spell and Math Tutorials. In today's tutorial, we're going to work with the discriminant. In this particular example, we're going to have one, the number of roots will be one, and the nature of the roots will be real. So here we have the expression for the discriminant, b squared minus 4ac. If that resolves to a value of zero, then we meet the criteria for this number and nature of roots, which is one real root. All right, first thing I want to do is to label our a, b, and c. In our polynomial here, this is understood to have a 1 in front, and that will be the a value. We have the b value of negative 6. I'm using parentheses because I want to make sure I capture the negatives if the coefficient is negative. And then the last value, c, this constant is 9. So now we're going to substitute these values back into the discriminant. So b squared is going to be negative 6 squared minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is 9. So here I have a negative 6 squared, which is 36. I have a negative times a positive, which will remain negative. 4 times 1 is 4, and 4 times 9 is 36. And when I resolve that, 36 minus 36, I end up with 0, and 0 does equal 0. So with that, I know that I'm going to have a situation where the parabola is either going to open up, where it's only going to touch the x-axis in one place, or the parabola is going to open downward, and again, it's only going to touch in one place. Let's take a look at Desmos to see what this particular equation looks like. So here we have the equation x squared minus 6x plus 9, or the function, and here we see that it is a parabola opening upward, and it's only making contact here on the x-axis at the value of 3. So that meets the criteria of what we were working with, and this is the graphical representation of that. All right, well, this sums up this tutorial by Spell or Math Tutorials. If you like it, please like it. And as always, thanks for watching.